Hi everyone, if you're new to the channel, my name is Elsa and I'm a software engineer working at a big tech company, and in this video I'm going to show you how I built my website from scratch in 7 days. Back when I was studying at uni, I bought my domain elsascola.com, and it's already been a few years since I last updated it, and I would like to have something that looks a bit more professional, a bit more mature, something that doesn't look like a student-made website and that I can use to present my work, link to my socials. You know, I've been postponing it for so long, it's something that I've been wanting to do for a while. So I wanted kind of to give myself a deadline of 7 days so I could really force myself to do it. I'm gonna be starting now. The first thing that I'm gonna be doing before actually building the website is doing some brainstorming. I'm gonna be having a look at different websites that can serve me as inspiration and do some mood boarding to see if I can figure out what I actually want. So let's get to do that right now. Okay, so as you can see, today I put together some kind of inspirational board where I put the websites that inspire me, a couple of fonts that I think would fit my aesthetic. I wanted something more modern looking instead of some serif fonts, just because I feel like they fit a bit more my tech vibe. And then as for the colors, I went for some more earthy tones, which I think really fit the aesthetic of my channel. So yeah, the next step is gonna be designing the prototype in Figma. As you guys just saw, I've been building the prototype of the website in Figma. Of course, this is not an elaborated wireframe or anything like that. This is just an easy way for me to get a sense of how the colors fit together and also if the font fits with the aesthetics of the website. So tomorrow I'm gonna start working on the actual website. Okay, so we're currently in day 6 of this challenge. You might be wondering what happened with day 4 and 5. Well, as you can see, I got a haircut. I also went to the theater. Yesterday I had dinner with some friends. You know, life just happens and I'm not gonna say no to fun plans, but I also wanted to give myself like a deadline to actually make it happen. So we still have 2 days to go. For my website, I'm gonna be using WordPress. You might be wondering, Elsa, you're a software engineer. Why would you use WordPress to do your website? You can just code it, right? If you're just starting out with web development, and of course, I would recommend that you try to code your own website at first, just so you can learn the concepts. So for me, it doesn't really make sense to code my website from scratch, given that this is a pretty normal, standard looking website. Actually, WordPress incorporates enough flexibility for you to include your own code if you want to tweak some specific stuff, but you can also leverage the templates that they offer. It provides many security updates and also makes it super easy to maintain. It has a whole management system inside that lets you create posts, set them as drafts, and it's very, very easy to manage the whole workflow. So that's another huge reason why I would use WordPress in this case. And if you're thinking about getting started with programming and software engineering, a great way to do this is through brilliant.org, which is kindly sponsoring this video. The first time I started using Brilliant was back in 2017 when I was at uni, and I still use it to this day to keep my math and science skills up to date. Brilliant.org is the best way to learn math and computer science interactively. Brilliant has thousands of lessons from foundational and advanced computer science, cryptocurrency, neural networks, and more. And they keep adding new lessons every month. If you're an aspiring software engineer, I would recommend you do the course on Computer Science Fundamentals. This course will teach you the basics of computational thinking in an intuitive way. It's easy to understand even if you come from a non-science background. My favorite thing about Brilliant is that it's built for busy people. The courses are divided in bite-sized lessons that you can make progress on with just 15 minutes a day during your commute or your coffee break. To try Brilliant for 30 days completely for free, visit brilliant.org/elsascola or click in the link in the description. And the first 200 of you will get a 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription. So today is day 7, today is the day of the reveal. So yeah, I made it on time and I think it looks quite decent. I mean, it's a very simple website, but I think it's a pretty good starting point. I'm definitely gonna be adding things to it. As you can see, this is kind of a presentation website. Brands can work with me directly from here. There's also a book section where I recommend my favorite books. And then there's a link to my newsletter where you can just like type your email and you will subscribe to my newsletter. Let me know if you'd like me to do a more in-depth video on how I did this website. I just don't know how technical you guys want me to be. As always, thank you so much for watching this video and I will see you guys in the next one.